Hello family, this is Gamers Forum back with another interesting video on Clash of Kings. So guys, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe to our business channel. You fully focused on tips and tricks regarding Clash of Kings. You'll get all the necessary data and details for each and every event over this channel. So guys, in today's video, we are going to cover out the COK Team Invitational Tournament. So we are going to cover this one. I'm going to tell you that what are the minimum efforts that you can go on to collect the 2000 points to get out the rewards, guys. So let's have a view and let me tell you everything that is being regarding this one. Let's enter the battlefield and we'll try to discuss the things out in there, guys. So guys, keep that in mind. If you are going to achieve 2000 points only, whether you are winning, whether you are losing, 2000 points are necessary for you to gain points, guys. Keep that in mind. If you want rewards, you need to go on with 2000 points for sure, guys. So guys, you can see out here, I think that none of the enemy and anyone have joined on. So first thing that you need to do is try to occupy more and more buildings, guys. The first thing that you need to do is just try to get out as much as space, try to occupy all the buildings and get away up to the palace, guys. Because this particular main palace is going to place a very important role in getting quick 2000 points. If you have any of the opponent in the battlefield, if you are getting opponent, then the getting point is quite easy. Kill the enemy's troops. If you are able to win over the enemy's troops, then you can easily get out 2000 points without any cause. But if there are no opponent and you have a time shortage out there, that particular point, now this particular video is going to help you a lot, guys. Let's have a view out what the first thing that you need to do, let me tell you, is try to get out the path to the palace. I'm going to trying to reach out. So basic requirement thing that is being needed for 2000 point is that you need only and only one teletransport, okay? Just one teletransport and just these some of the horses. Try to send out horses for occupying these buildings. The reason is that horses are quite fast as compared to the other troops. That's why it is going to consume less time to travel out these paths. So I'm going to skip this particular portion. Let me unlock some of the parts and after that I will tell you that what are the things that you need to do out with that particular point, guys. Okay, so let's skip this portion and I am going to quickly get points as much as I can. So guys, you can see out here, I have occupied all the way to the palace. So all the main buildings that are in my particular route to the palace is being covered on, and finally my palace is going to be unlocked. You can see out here, now I can occupy the palace. So keep that in mind, guys. If you are alone, then you can go with the palace, because whether you can go inside the palace with any number of troops, means if you are alone, there is no opponent and no of your teammates are just joined on, then you can send any number of troops. But keep in mind, guys, there is only 20 minutes that you need to occupy this palace, because after 20 minutes you will automatically get the victory. So in 20 minutes only you have the chance to occupy 2000 points whenever you are alone and you don't have any of the particular enemy at your side. Keep that in mind, because if a small mistake can get out a big deal from you, you can lose out your whole hard work that you have done for around 20 to 25 to 30 minutes in the battlefield, guys. So the bonus point is that whether any quantity of troops in the palace, you are going to get some of the additional rewards from the palace. Means palace automatically gives you some of the points. Keep that in mind. So this is the benefit of occupying the palace. If you are going for reinforcing the palace with your allies, then I don't think that only the occupier is going to get out those points or benefit of those points. So keep that in mind. Try to achieve the palace to get out the more points at particular one. This is the first source of getting points, that is by occupying the palace. Okay, after that, guys, let's move to the another sources. The another sources out here for occupying this one is that you can develop the areas, and whenever you are developing on, keep that in mind, try to develop with the maximum of the marches. Okay, maximum of the marches. For that one, there are different of the technologies. There are two different technologies. First one is the camp attack. In the camp attack, you can enhance your attacking skills, whether it is damage boost, health attack, counter features, you can increase out these particular thing. You can go with this one whenever you are having opponent at this particular battlefield, keep that in mind. But whenever you are not having any of the opponent, you can go with the camp technology basic increment. It can increase your marching speed, okay, it can increase your legion, the amount of troop that you can use for the marching. These are the things that you can do on at this particular scene, guys. And basic the point increment also, increment rate can also be increased. This is the basic development that you can get from this particular, so keep that in mind. As the leader doesn't join this particular one, so that's why I'm not able to go with that particular thing, okay. Means I am not able to unlock any of the skills, whether it is of camp development or camp attack, because the leader or the subordinate of the leader can only select these particular skills according to the current rule, guys. But I am getting points. You can see out here in the comparison section, you can see out here I just get my troops inside the palace and I have already achieved 100 points. You can see out. So basically, if you are able to achieve the palace, then you can easily able to achieve 2000 points without any cause or without any difficulty from your side. So keep that in mind. These are the particular things that you have to keep in mind. There are two different sources of getting points. First one is the particular palace that can give you a huge number of points, keep that in mind. And second one is the development, guys. You can see out here in each development after 6 minutes I'm going to get 412 points from the development, as I have to use all the loading troops. Means the troop load, the troops having the maximum troop load, I have used that one. That's why it is gonna means much load of the troops that you are setting, sending on more points, it will going to come up and more time it is going to consume for getting it done, guys. So keep that in mind. So 400 for 6 minutes is not a bad deal. So 400 for 6 minutes I am also getting some of the points from here also, from the palace also. You can see out here 171 points just from the palace only, guys. So you have 20 minutes after occupying palace to complete your 2000 of the points. So guys, don't panic on. All you have to focus on is to occupy 2000 points. That is the only main goal that you are having on. This is the easiest way of getting these things. I have told you how to get points, I have told you what are the researches, I have told you the method of gaining points. So these are the only things. Just keep in mind that whenever you are getting in this particular battlefield, don't try to lose 2000 points. Whether you are winning, whether you are losing, just the only goal that you have to achieve in this particular battlefield is 2000 points. Because 2000 points is the only key to getting all the rewards, whether you are at the winning or at the losing points side, guys. So I'm going to skip this section, and after the victory I will give you an overview that what are the rewards that you are getting from the winning of this particular competition of this COK Team Carnival tournament rewards, so that you can get an overview that this particular event is worth joining or not, guys. So please have patience, just be quick. It will be a small wait, it will be a swap of fingers, and you will get to know everything that is being necessary for the reward section, guys. So let's skip this out. So guys, 20 minutes was almost going to be over by now. You can see out only 10 seconds left, and if I have occupied the palace, I have occupied the some of the particular one by developing the area, and you can see out here I have easily scored 2900 of the points, guys. Yes guys, without any particular difficulty in the 20 minutes of this particular section is only the time I have consumed to obtain 2900 of the points. Keep that in mind. And same thing you have to do on, you don't have to do anything else. Just try to get one of the march in the palace, one for the developing. And if you have a leader in and you can unlock multiple of the marches, then you can unlock it with sending two or three marches to the developing. But one of the marches should be at the palace to get out the maximum of the free points, guys. And now let's move to the rewards. As we have grabbed the victory, and now let's have a, you can see out here 100 of the 2 hour training speed up, you are going to get COK legend world domination optional chest, you are going to get 40 200k of the mithril cross 10, 800k of iron cross 10, 2 hour wounded speed up 100, 5 million of wood cross 10, magic
essence 25 reserve stones, 10,000 golden box of faith, guys. Yes, guys, this particular reward is quite rare and is very much useful because these faith boxes are available only with the purchase only, and some of the events are only going to give you these things. So one of the event is this particular one, so don't miss out this particular reward. It is going to be very much helpful, guys, for the amulet feature. 5 million of food, cross 10, 8 hour speed up, cross 25, 100k of the hero experience, cross 25, knight heraldry 200, not bad. Feathers of heaven 8,000 of the number, guys. This particular reward is also rare and very much helpful for the training of T14 of the soldiers, guys. Civilization crystal 10,000, lucky stones 1,000, guys. So rewards are really good because only 25 to 30 minutes are only thing that you are investing in this particular one, and in return if you are getting these rewards, it is quite very much helpful. And just after spending some of the time, these rewards are really sure and very much helpful, guys. So that's all about today's video. I hope that you guys like the video content. If you find the video information useful, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for sure. I will be back with another video as soon as possible. Till then, keep going with Gamers Forum. Thank you, guys.